My bad.
What is up, YouTube? It's your boy Marky here with another video. So I recently did some games with my good buddy Kazix May Jump, and we decided to do a series on which ADCs pair the best with Ashe support and which don't. Wins and losses will be recorded on his channel. I will be doing the replay analysis to discover, in my personal opinion, does that ADC pair well or fail? So, without further ado, let's get on with it. Let's get on with the first one. The first one that we did was Jhin ADC. So, we did fairly well early, but then mid late we started to fall off and we almost lost. But I mean, we'll analyze our mistakes and come to the conclusion. So, and as y'all know, if y'all don't know already, I am a Jhin main, so I did have a little bit of doubts in the beginning, and you may hear me raging on Kazan, but because I was raging. We were doing kind of fairly well, and then until Thresh started landing hooks, he started landing the hooks like crazy, and we early game we could not do anything, and we had no choice but to push it as far into the late game as we could to try to pull a late game ass miracle, and so we did our best. I will let the whole replay run before I make my decision, but Jhin is one of those ADCs, honestly, in my opinion. Jhin is one of those ADCs that works best with a support that can snare, stun, or slow his enemy so he can get his snares off. But it doesn't. I mean, if you're good with Jhin, it kind of doesn't matter late game, because late game, if you've kept up with your farm and you've got maybe at least 120 farm by 30 minutes, you should be okay regardless late game, because you've got most of your gold income coming in from your farm anyhow from Jhin anyway, because he's not because he doesn't attack fast, so he's not one of those champions that could just go kill. His mostly early mid game is mostly farming, but we will let the whole replay run and give our analysis based on what happens. So, first things first, y'all know me, I don't like the fog of war, and I don't like the target frame, so let's turn those off. I like to know where everything is, so I got fog of war off now, and then I got the target frames off, so I could not do much farming early. I did kind of well on farming. I saved way more than all that. I did kind of good, but at the same time, I kind of failed because I was a little bit too focused on getting kills when Ka went in, and it kind of bit me in the butt because early game I was not able to get my farm on like a true Jhin main. I was just gonna chase Ka, help him get kills, and it was just that was the worst decision I could have made, because this Thresh started to catch on to us, and he just said, you know what, fuck you, I'm hooking your asses. That's how it went. See? Land in that hook. Peace out, man. He landed a lot of those, though. That's the thing. His hooks were on... This Thresh's hooks were on point. They were on point. I was raging so hard at COD, Discord and Skype. I think we're in Skype for this one. But I was raging down at COD so freaking hard because I couldn't do anything. I was mad. I was oh my god, I wanted to freaking kill myself. Y'all know how I get. I get in that role and I was just I want to freaking die right now. I can't put my speakers in right now. So this video is just going to be me talking and me analyzing the game. There will be no sound for this video and the next one. The next two that I'm going to upload, there will be no sound. So don't expect any sound because it's early in the morning. It's 5:30 in the morning and I can't have my speakers in right now because it'll wake everybody up, and I don't want to do that. So we'll just analyze the game as it plays, and we won't have any sound cues. My next videos will have more than likely have sound, but this one will not. I apologize if you want the sound. There just can't be sound in this one, and because of it being too early in the game. I couldn't do anything about that. Paris got first blood. I really couldn't do anything about it. It was like she had to die, and it was like, oh, this.
Inspire me.
Waste my flash there is like I'm not getting a double kill. If I have to lose my flash, he is not getting a double kill. That was my thinking. It says even if I have to lose my flash on that, I am not giving him first blood double kill. First blood double kill would have spiraled this Vera so hard he would have put an unkillable late game. But I was like, nope, I am not about to let that first blood double kill happen. It's just not today. Any other time than him getting a double kill is fine, but that first blood double kill, that is not happening. Not happening. Not on my watch, at least. Of that, the only thing on that is incorrect that we did not get was the heal. I wasn't paying too much attention, and he didn't get the heal. Varus's heal was still on, and I was like, I'm a dumbass on that. I thought it was gone, and it wasn't. And it's like, okay. Skype, Discord, or any type voice chat service, perhaps, but because they were performing really well, and I gotta commend them for that. They were doing very well. It's just late game we had the better comp, and I mean you saw we won this. Y'all saw it said victory. So I mean, you know, just late game we had the better comp. I scaled a little bit better than Varus did, and it's like in the end, and it's like, you know, what can we do? Early game here. Kyle was trying to explain this to me. This is my very first game when Ashe is my support, so I wasn't aware that they weren't gonna do enough damage to kill me, and I was just a little bit too afraid, and I was too afraid to go in because I was afraid to get hooked by the Thresh that insta-killed by the Varus, but... And late game I kind of learned my lesson here, and I was like, okay, if my buddy Khan goes in, I'm gonna go in, and I'm gonna do my best to get killed. this Amumu was pretty bad at jungling, but we're not here to analyze all of this. We're here to analyze whether Jhin is good paired with Ashe as his support for ADC. So, when letting the replay go here, I'm just letting the replay go where it wants here. And just like, because that's the way I usually do it, and we can still analyze from the bird's eye view the fact of letting the replay go wherever it needs to go. In the nutshell of this, I do believe that we made a lot of stupid mistakes, and it's just like nothing we could do. I mean, we made so many dumb mistakes early. It was just, okay, what are we gonna do here?
I don't know.
Early game here, there was nothing I could do at all times. Our mid lane would never ping when her enemy was missing. Our top lane, literally just couldn't do anything against that gangplank until like late game. It was like, okay. You know, in the end, whatever happens, happens. It was like, okay. We had no choice but to play it. We had no choice but to play it with whatever happens, happens game, because we were early game, we were just like, we were so far behind early. We had to play it till late. We had to force it till late game, and it was like the whole time I was like, I want to freaking die right now, because it was just like, I have never had a game this late game dependent in a really long time when I'm playing Jhin. If y'all have seen some of my live streams of me playing Jhin ADC, you know a lot of times my bot lane goes incredibly hard. It's like, I don't ever have to worry about outscaling late because my ADC just feeds me, and it's like, me never having an Ashe as my support kind of helped me. Honestly, in this particular game, kind of helped me back a little bit because I wasn't used to it, and it was kind of a shock to me. But my friend Kazix may jump here. He mains Ashe support, so it's a bit. He was trying to teach me how to work with him and the bot lane, and this was like the first game. So you guys are gonna notice I'm gonna get progressively better as with my engages and with him. We're eventually just gonna get to the point where any ADC I pick is just gonna dominate. Single kill on this ult. That was like, that's one of my worst ults that I've ever fired right there. Was I happy when I fired that ult? Yeah. Did I think I was gonna get a kill? Perhaps. I thought maybe I'd get the virus, but luck would have it, the thrash body blocked for him.
You can go rest if you want to. I keep hearing you're like yawning.
Oh wow, see that was a bad ult on top right there. If they would have landed that, perhaps maybe we could have gotten the virus. that recalled on me. I should have honestly ran under the turret, then recalled. I think I probably would have been okay there. It's alright though. We all made mistakes in this game. Cassidy made his fair share. Ari made his fair share. I made my fair share. I can't not tell you that. I can't tell you that I didn't make my fair share of mistakes. Because I made a hell of a lot more mistakes than I should have this game. And so did Carr. And then in the end, I thought it was going to bite us in the ass. But, hey, you know, what happens? It's what happens when your team works together, I suppose. And whatever. This next team fight here was the defining moment of this, is to decide who would win this, ultimately based on how fast the other team can burst the one team. I think that maybe this next team fight here was the deciding factor. But, you know, it's like, you do what you do, and then I said the moment here, like, why would you go in that direction? Why? He's honestly lucky Ari was there to save him. Otherwise, that Sharpa would have just flat shit on him. Especially considering that he had health over there. He was like, you know, okay. That was a terrible ult. He missed it slightly, and it was like, damn, if he would have shot that, I could have came in, could have came charged in with my U-moves and perhaps got an auto attack off, or at the very low, at least pop my ult for some slight damage, allowing my team to pick up a kill. But no, maybe. I mean, I was pretty damn far away from that. So maybe I'm over exaggerating what I could have done here. I mean, I'm a little bit. I was really far away. And then I started coming in and out here, and I was too late to save the Ari. And then. Gangplank ducked and covered behind Flash, and I didn't kill him. I should have ulted like a second earlier. Perhaps I would have been able to kill him. Maybe that's what Mumu was expecting me. He was probably there. He's probably expecting me to ult the Gangplank so that I'd get the kill. But the way I was thinking it is, Mumu's gonna die, so I got one of two options. I can ult and hope for at least my crit shot to kill him, or just let the Mumu die because he was terrible at engage. So I mean, it was like at that point my choice was clear. I just like, I'm letting you die. You haven't done a single good thing this entire fight. So I was like, this entire game. Every time you've went in, something bad has ultimately happened, and I was like, you know, I'm not dealing with this. I'm just gonna let you die, and then try to help the rest of my team. I knew that was the fake, but I could not do anything. I had no choice but to kill it because it was chasing me. So, yeah, I know it was the fake. Kinda tell, because the fake takes more damage than the original Shackle. Another good way to tell is if you play a jhin and you can heat the real shako steps over one of your flowers, it will reveal the real shako between the two of them. Just the clone stepping over it won't do a damn thing. But it still will trigger the flower, but it will reveal the real one when he steps over one of them, like, say by accident, or you toss it directly underneath him before he ults. It will immediately trigger the flower, ultimately revealing the real shako before his ult even goes off. That's a good tip right there. Just picking up jhin, if you have a shako, you're versing a shako on the other end of the jungle. Your team has a shako, your other team has a shako jungle, that's a good tip for you. Keep them flowers around so you can track their real shako no matter where he goes. That's something I should have done this game, but I did not have good placement with my flower. Oh, sorry, I'm tired here. I'm just trying to do this video for a cause so I can go to sleep. And I got two more that I gotta upload for him, but I'll do those later. I want to get this jhin one up there for him before I head to bed. So. So as you can see here, we started turning around a little bit, so it's more or less just the fact, like I said, that we scaled a little bit better than they did late game. I think I got Varus. No, I missed him. I missed my W on him. I'm like, no, I'm not even gonna bother engaging there. I can't hit my W. My whole team, like, revenue here, idea was, if I can't hit my W, then I'm not even gonna bother going in on somebody. If my W doesn't land, my late game, my team fight strategy was put simple this. W no land, jhin no go in. That was what I decided. Now, if my team did land, like, hard CC on somebody, I would initiate. But other than that, if my W did not land, I did not go in. I was just like, nope, my W it's not going off, it didn't hit, and it's like, there's no point. I think this Shaco was building AP. He was going to AP Shaco. Cause a lot of times when he threw his E out, I saw the runic echoes go off. So I think he was building AP Shaco. Why don't we look and find out? Yeah, he was going AP Shaco. Okay. I haven't seen that in a while. The last time I saw that, I think it was a support Shaco. It was an old friend of mine. But I won't get into too much detail about that. But basically, the gist of it is full AP, build full AP, and support the Shaco. It does kind of do it. It's just more or less how much. It's just more or less how badly does your team want kills versus how badly does, or how first, not but how aggressive your Shaco support ends up being. Heh. wing is.
Shut down. Haste.
This Varus got pretty fucking bad. I didn't understand his build though. It's his build was half AP, half AD. It's like I did not understand his build. It, early it seemed to work for him, but late it seemed to, whatever he was building late game seemed to fall off. And same thing with the Shaco. That's one thing with AP Shaco. Towards mid end game it starts to fall for damage. Starts to fall off a little bit because you're relying a little bit too much on your jack in the box just to get kills. That's why it kind of falls off because you're relying way too late game, mid late, you're relying a little bit more on the jack in the boxes than you should be. And your auto attacks don't do as much damage, so it's more or less you're missing out on a little bit of that extra burst that you would get. I didn't realize that Cassidy did so great. I mean, oh my god, he got that double kill, almost as miracle live. Jeez, imagine if he would live there. Then he would probably have been like a triple on the barrels before he died. And he did beat pretty dang fast, and he did have some pretty tough CC to deal with. But, you know, man, maybe not. Maybe I'm a bit exaggerating a little bit, as I was before, maybe. Maybe I'm a little bit over-exaggerating.
Disconnected.
Hey,
here. This team fight right here, we were going off like there ain't no tomorrow. Like, I have, like, I still missed every single shot on my ult, but somehow managed to get pull off at least one good snare and get a kill off. That was, honestly, that was one of my more actually was one of my only my only notable play in this entire game. After that, I just, early and after, from that point, I spiked up a little bit and then just crashed right back down again, basically. It was like, you know, I'll just try my best at this point because I never got fed on Jhin. I mean, you guys saw it. I never got fed, so my objective was simply put this. Help my team as much as I can. Stay in the back line, shoot my ult, and hope I hit something. And as I said, my W, if my W didn't land, I didn't go in. A little too late there. Had I ulted a second earlier, perhaps maybe I could have slowed down the game. As I ulted, he was more as before I even ulted him, he was out of my range. Second kill was kind of a chaos because Moomoo did get most of the damage, and I came in and I'm like, I just took his kill. I mean, that was disrespectful to the Moomoo. I should have let the Moomoo have that, but it's like, this is late game now, so it's like, whoever gets the kills gets the kills. So, you know, you can't really contest anything because, you know, it's like, it's late game now, and it's whoever kills it, and you can't bitch anymore because the laning phase is over, so there is no such thing as "that was my kill." No, it's mid-late game. There is no such thing as a kill steal because mid-late game, it's all about acing the enemy team and pushing into their base for the win. That's what it is. And there is no such... There honestly is no such thing as a kill steal mid-late, in my opinion. Do people still bitch and complain and whine saying that other people are kill stealing them? Yeah, but are they? No, because mid-late game, it doesn't matter. It's about who does the most damage to whom and who gets the kill. Like, it depends on who does that most damage.
Thank you.
I overstayed my welcome, it seems, at that point right there. Shot, I did not think I was gonna hit. I lagged the second my ult went off, and I just fired something randomly, and I'm like, oh my god, I actually hit something. That shot surprised the out of me. I honestly thought I wasn't even gonna hit it, but I hit it, and it's like, wow. So, here's where the game ended. So, in my honest opinion, now, does Jhin scale well with Ashe as his support? In the right hands, yes. Is it late game reliant with Ashe's Jhin as Jhin's support? Yeah. But Is it possible for you to win with Jhin with Ashe as your ADC? Yes. So my answer is, yeah. Jhin does work well with Ashe, but it is incredibly late game reliant. That'll be it for this video, guys. Thanks for watching. I will leave a link to Kha'Zix Made Jump's channel in the description. See you in the next video.